Good morning, all of you, dear students. A fresh good morning to all of you. Today, in this video, we will discuss about a chapter number 4, that is subject and predicate of class 8 English grammar. So today, we will discuss about grammar portion, chapter number 4, subject and predicate. So, dear students, before going to this new topic, we have discussed. I want to recap your previous grammar classes. That we have discussed about sentence, okay, your phrases, okay. So today we will discuss about the subject and predicate. So before going to this, we need to know that this subject and predicate are present in a sentence, okay. So a sentence has two parts. First part is the subject part, and the second part is your predicate part. Okay, a sentence contains two parts. First part is your subject part, and the second part is your predicate part, or we can say it as a object part. So, what do you mean by sentence? I have already taught you. Okay, what do you mean by sentence? Okay, so today we will discuss about subject and predicate. Okay, so a sentence says or states something or expresses strong feelings. Either it asks questions. Okay, so this kind of things we look into a sentence. So we have discussed about types of sentences also. Okay, so there are basically four types of sentences: passive sentence, interrogative sentence, imperative sentence, and exclamatory sentence. So we do find four types of sentences. Okay, but assertive, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory. Okay, so these all contains these are all four different types of sentences. Okay, so this subject and predicate are present in the sentence itself. Okay, so we need to find out that which is the subject part and which is the predicate part. So a subject may be a noun or a pronoun. Okay, the subject may be a noun or pronoun, while the predicate part is the second part of the sentence which says something about the subject. Okay, predicate, it is that part of the sentence, is that part of the sentence which says something. It is that part of the sentence which says something about the subject. Okay, get it? So a sentence contains two parts. First part is your subject part, and the second one is your predicate part, or we can say it as an object part. Okay, so what is subject? A subject may be a noun or a pronoun. Okay, but predicate, it is that part of the sentence which says something about the subject. So I am writing sentences where we have to look the subject part and the predicate part. Okay, first one is your the police got the thing, got the
into the home. To the things. Students, look at these two sentences. The police or the thief. Second sentence, she dived into the swimming pool. So, where is the subject part here in the first sentence? The police, it is the subject part. Okay? It is the subject part. In the second sentence, where do we find the subject part? Here is the subject part. So, a subject may be a noun or a pronoun. Subject may be a noun, police is a noun, common noun, and she is a pronoun. Okay, she is a pronoun. So a subject may be a noun or a pronoun. Similarly, the second part of the sentence is called a predicate part, and the predicate part of the sentence contains verb. So what are verbs? Verbs are action words. Okay. They state something which action, they state some action is going on. Okay, so the second part is your predicate part. This one is your predicate part for. Okay, past tense of case is for. What is your verb? Okay, what is your verb? So predicate contains a verb part. So what is the verb? So, this is your predicate part. Similarly, in the second sentence, if we went out, then this part is your predicate part. Okay, the second sentence, this part is your predicate part. Okay, that is, so a subject could be a noun or a pronoun. Noun or a pronoun. Predicate is that part of the sentence that says something about the subject. This part of the sentence says something about the subject or the key. This part says something about the police. Okay. Similarly, the second sentence, this part of the sentence says something about the subject. And also, the predicate part of the sentence contains verb, die, or all the action words are called your verb. Okay. You get it? Thank you. us that the sentence which simply says something or states something are called you as a three sentence. A. This three sentences simply states something or says something here. Miller is going to fear. Okay. Here, manner we see interrogative sentences. Not your exclamatory or your imperative sentence. So it is completely a fear sentence that Mira is going to fail. Mira is going to appear. Okay. Mira is going to fail. Okay. Mira is going to appear. Second sentence is that the little girl has read. Third sentence, girl is wearing a red scarf. Okay, so all these three sentences, they simply say something. Okay, they did ask question that who is going to read. Okay, so in order to know, suppose we go to the subject. Okay, here we find that it is a sentence. Okay, so here, a while before, told you about the subject and predicate part. That subject is could be the noun or the pronoun. So here we find that Mira is noun, the rest part your Mira is subject part and the rest part is your predicate part. Okay, suppose we don't know the subject. Okay, we read the sentence name. Okay, and we have to identify that which is the subject one and which is the predicate one. Suppose we don't know the subject or predicate. So in order to know the subject and predicate, we have to interrogate that sentence. We have to ask that sentence questions. Okay, so how can we ask questions? These are all your assertive sentences. Okay, these are all your assertive sentences. So how can, if we don't know the subject, then how can we know whether the sentence contains a subject or not? So in order to know the subject, we have to ask question with the sentence. Okay, Mira is going to a fair. So you can ask question to sentence that who is going to a fair. Who is going to a fair? Then definitely we will get the answer that Mira is going to a fair. So here Mira act as your subject. The second sentence, the little girl has fair. Well, the answer would be little girl. The answer will be little girl. In the third sentence, the girl is wearing red scarf. Who is wearing a red scarf? Okay. So in this way, we can ask question to the sentence in order to know the subject part. Okay. So these are all your what? Interrogative questions. These are all interrogative questions or interrogative sentences. These are your assertive sentences. Okay. समझ में आया कि नहीं बच्चों? देखो, हम लोग हैं आज यहाँ पे सब्जेक्ट और प्रेडिकेट पढ़ेंगे तो हमको पता है कि सेंटेंस में सब्जेक्ट भी होगा प्रेडिकेट भी क्या है होता है तो उसका जो सेंटेंस है वो दो पार्ट में क्या है डिवाइड होता है एक पार्ट दो पार्ट सब्जेक्ट पार्ट जो रहते हैं प्रेडिकेट रहते हैं ऑब्जेक्ट पार्ट तो सब्जेक्ट पार्ट में क्या है नाउन भी रह सकते हैं और प्रोनाउन भी रह सकते हैं तो प्रोनाउन क्या है नाउन की जगह में जो वर्ड यूज होता है उसको प्रोनाउन बोला जाता है ओके जैसे रोहित इज प्लेइंग फुटबॉल रोहित इज प्लेइंग फुटबॉल ही ऑल्सो प्लेइंग क्रिकेट तो हमें डबल रोहित को यूज नहीं कर सकते तो नाम की जगह में जो वर्ड यूज होता है उसको नाम बोला जाता है तो सब्जेक्ट एक नाम हो सकता है या फिर क्या प्रोनाउन भी हो सकता है और साथ में है हमने क्या है प्रेडिकेट पार्ट पढ़ा ठीक है तो प्रेडिकेट पार्ट वो है जो कि सब्जेक्ट के बारे में कुछ बताता है समझे सब्जेक्ट के बारे में कुछ बताता है और प्रेडिकेट पार्ट जो है वर्ब रहता है समझे वर्ब जो है वो एक्शन वर्ड्स है तो हम किसी सेंटेंस में जब देखेंगे हम देखते हैं कि वर्ब है तो हम समझ जाएंगे कि वो predicate part kya hai है मैंने ये तीन sentences लिखा है here is going to appear the little girl as well the girl is wearing red scarf ये चाहे simple sentences है हमने पिछले क्लास में पढ़ाया था types of sentences that हमारे पास ये चार types of sentences होते हैं कौन से assertive interrogative impediment explanatory sentence समझे तो ये सब क्या है assertive sentences है तो मान लो कि हमको ऐसे सेंटेंस दिया हुआ है और बोला गया है कि तुमको सब्जेक्ट और प्रेडिकेट निकालो बोला गया है तो हम कंफ्यूज हो जाएंगे अगर हमको पता नहीं होगा सब्जेक्ट पार्ट कौन सा है प्रेडिकेट पार्ट कौन सा है तो सब्जेक्ट पार्ट निकालने के लिए हमको क्या करना पड़ेगा कि क्वेश्चन जो क्वेश्चन है सेंटेंस है उसको क्या है क्वेश्चन करना है पूछना है ये सेंटेंस है उसको पूछना है कैसे पूछोगे जो सब्जेक्ट पार्ट है ना वहाँ पर गुण या वर्ड लगा कर क्या है क्वेश्चन बनाएंगे मेरा इस बैंक में मेरा जो मैंने क्या किया तू लगाया मतलब मुझे पता चल जाएगा कि वो कौन है वो बुला है जो कि क्या है मेला देखने जा रही है सिमिलरली सेकंड सेंटेंस में जो छोटी सी बच्ची वो क्या है बहुत सुंदर क्या है डांस की गर्ल इज वेरिंग रेड स्कार्फ वो लड़की है जो कि क्या है रेड स्कार्फ पहनी हुई है तो यहाँ पे भू लगा दिया गर्ल के लिए क्या है भू लगा इज वेरिंग रेड स्कार्फ गर्ल तो हम उनको क्या है इस तरह से सब्जेक्ट और प्रेडिकेट पता चल जाएगा सो इन एन असर्टिव सेंटेंस द वर्ब इज प्रेजेंट वर्ड सब्जेक्ट इज प्रेजेंट बिफोर द वर्ब ओके इन एन असर्टिव सेंटेंस द सब्जेक्ट इज प्रेजेंट बिफोर ए वर्ब ओके part, we have discussed two parts, both assertive sentence and interpretive sentence. sentence. So what are imperative sentences? Imperative sentences are those sentences that expresses a strong or expresses a request, command, or gives an advice. Okay, so we have discussed it in our previous class. Okay, so if someone asks you question, you to find out imperative sentence, then by seeing the sentence, we have to guess that whether it is an imperative sentence or exclamatory sentence, to find out that sentence easily. Okay, similarly, exclamatory sentence are those sentences which expresses a strong feeling. So whenever we see a sentence that ends with this mark, exclamation mark, whenever we see a sentence that ends with this mark, then we can simply identify the sentence as an exclamatory sentence. Okay.
Or E for your exclamatory sentence.
write the sentences as A means assertive, I N means interpretive, I M means imperative, or E means your explanatory sentence. So you have to identify whether these sentences are assertive, interpretive, imperative, or explanatory sentence. First one, switch off the light. Here from command is given. So if we find a request, command, or advice, then we simply identify it as an imperative sentence. I want to make it a simple sentence. Simple sentences are the assertive sentence. Where is my pencil box? Here is half question. And where is the pencil box? So if you have question, then that sentence would be your imperative sentence. How old it is? Yes, in this mark. Simply, what will be sentence you have to identify. Give me your pen, please. Here, a request is making over. Okay. So, if you find any request, command, advice, then we will refer to as imperative sentence. So, this is all about the subject and predicate. So, I want to request you that please be at your home. Clean your hands thoroughly with soap or sanitizers so as to avoid corona. So stay home and stay safe and enjoy your online classes. Thank you, students.